You're checking out the longest running online radio show on the iPower Evening Show. DeMarco J on Pretty Ricky and Stefan Mason.
It's time now for the Clown Donkey Hall of Shame.
What kind of fool am I?
Somebody done act a fool. Somebody done put their foot in their mouth.
The bottom line is, I think you're a complete jackass.
Worse than them females.
Now say some more. I'll knock your ass right back down, fake ass wannabe preaching no members having mother.
Time for that induction ceremony.
Me, just plain me. I might as well be working for white folks.
The iPower Evening Show.
Hi, this week's Clown Donkey Hall of Shame for Friday, May 24th, 2019, goes out to Mark Gomez. Now, this story happened back a couple months ago. It may be old news to some, but elder abuse is real, and we must talk about this. Now, I don't know who Mark Gomez is, but I know damn well he deserves this clown donkey for what I'm about to tell you what he did. By the way, this was in the Bronx, yep, BX in NYC. In the words of Charlemagne the God, the craziest people in America is the Bronx and all of Florida. And once again, Charlemagne was right. Now, don't get me wrong about the Bronx. The Bronx is known for the birth of hip-hop that we know today. Well, some of it is hip-hop, and not the trash we got out right now. Now, I'm talking about real rappers like Fat Joe, Big Pun, Melly Mel, the hip-hop founder, DJ Kool Herc. You also got D-Nice, Funkmaster Flex, Christopher Reed from Kid & Play, even Cardi B, Remy Ma, My Son, and more rappers that came out of the Bronx, repping NYC all day. These are rappers from today and yesteryear that put real hip-hop on the map. DeMarco, you love the Bronx, right?
Oh yeah, I love it.
Of course you do. Pelham Bay Park is your favorite stop.
Yes.
Matter of fact, the number 6 line is your favorite line on the MTA, right?
Yeah, it's one of them.
Now, despite of the crazy-ass people who live in the Bronx, despite that there is crazy-ass people who could give two F's about what they do to incriminate doing stupid-ish, that's what the Bronx is.
Right.
You gon' have crazy nuts out there.
Mm-hmm.
The Bronx is always in the news because of
crazy-ass people, but I love the Bronx.
You love the Bronx because you love taking the number 6 train to Pelham Bay.
Yep.
Or the number 1 train going to Van Cortlandt Park.
Yep.
Or the number 4 train going to Woodlawn, stopping at 161st Street at Yankee Stadium.
Oh, yeah.
Didn't you take the number 5 train to Eastchester?
Yes, I did. Yes, I did. I took the number 5 train to Eastchester.
Right.
I recently took the number 2 train to Wakefield in the Bronx.
Brother, I know you love the Bronx.
Oh, yeah, I have to admit, I do love the Bronx. Despite of the negative happening in the BX, not all of the Bronx is drug and criminal infested.
No.
There's some beautiful houses in the Bronx.
Yes,
and
there
and
is.
I ain't talking about the NYCHA housing projects.
No.
I'm talking about real homes that were built for low-income communities.
Yeah.
And the houses that look like you see in the suburbs.
Oh, yeah. They out there.
So not all of the Bronx is that bad.
No way.
But at least they still have elevated subway lines compared to Boston.
Yeah.
I have plenty of respect on the Bronx for that.
Well, that's because elevated lines in the Bronx, Brooklyn, Queens, and part of Manhattan are historically city landmarks.
Right.
Something that Boston don't know nothing about.
Are you kidding?
Because urban renewal destroyed their precious landmarks of elevated subway lines.
How sad.
But this is not about Boston. Let's go back to the matters at hand. And speaking of elevated subways, the reason why I'm giving Mark Gomez the Clown Donkey Hall of Shame is something that he did on the number 2 train that was very uncalled for, because this could have been your grandmother, your mama, your auntie. Now, as you know, I was born in Bed-Stuy, Brooklyn, grew up in Roxbury in Boston, moved back to New York with my wife, currently living in Staten Island. Now, when it comes to the MTA in NYC, I've witnessed things like couches, sofas, a refrigerator, a freezer, a big-ass Christmas tree, and exposed adult toys being taken on the New York City subway trains.
Yep.
Hey, it's New York. It's the Bronx.
Hello.
What you expect?
That ain't nothing
You
new.
Even had subway rats crawling on homeless people sleeping on the train.
Sorry.
Or a strange man literally pissing on a female passenger around 3 o'clock in the morning on an NYC subway train. Is that anything new to NYC?
Nah,
not really.
No,
but
not really.
This one takes the cake. Let's go to CBS2 for the report.
36-year-old Mark Gomez handcuffed, ignoring questions from reporters, and instead hanging his head in silence after this. When police say he repeatedly kicked 78-year-old Geraldine Chase, a homeless woman on the 2 train, as it pulled into the Nereid Avenue station near 238th Street. You see him strike the subway passenger in the face with his boot once, twice, then 4 more times on her body before yelling.
World saw that, man.
and walking off the train.
I think it's horrible. I think it's absolutely horrible, and it's just sad that this is happening and being recorded.
Oh my God, that's the worst of society right there. He deserves to be in jail forever.
Police say Gomez of Yonkers attacked her back on March 10th around 3 a.m. The video going viral on social media in recent days. Many wondering why no one stepped in to help.
That was my main reaction, is why was no one helping, you know, when they saw that happen.
As for the victim, police say she continued on the northbound train until the next stop, where she was treated by EMS workers for bleeding, swelling, and cuts on her face. The MTA calling the video sickening and condemning the despicable act. It's still unclear what provoked this.
Gomez is facing assault and harassment charges. Police tell us he has been arrested in the past, taken into custody last year for having a loaded shotgun.
Wow. One of the witnesses on that number two train said that this was an unprovoked attack, all because she, get that tape ready, bruh, all because the victim looked at him, took a glance at him before he went off on this poor defenseless 78-year-old lady who didn't deserve that kind of disrespect as a senior citizen and a proud resident of the Bronx.
This man is an animal. I hope they put him under the jail.
I mean, it was not like she was staring at the suspect.
Right.
It was not like she was mean mugging this guy.
Right.
It was a 2-second glance.
A 2-second glance.
This ain't an NYC or a BX thing.
No.
This happens everywhere on public transportation, wherever you at, in major cities across the country.
Right.
But sadly, this was in the Bronx, ladies and gentlemen. Nothing surprises me when it comes to one of the five boroughs in New York City called the Bronx. All I'm saying is, Mark Gomez, who has little respect for the elderly, you gonna know how that's gonna feel when NYPD's finest takes your lame punk ass on an island called Rikers. And we know Rikers is not a paradise. Ask the Browder family about Kalief Browder. It wasn't a paradise for him, spending 3 years at Rikers with no criminal record, no crime committed, no nothing. And we know the rest of the story on that unfortunate incident after 3 years in a hellhole. May Kalief Browder's soul rest in peace. But as for Mark Gomez, now that's a real criminal. Send him to Rikers, is where he's going, or where he's at as we speak, waiting for his trial. Not somebody like Kalief Browder. Please induct Mark Gomez into the Clown Donkey Hall of Shame.
Thanks, Ricky, on your Clown Donkey Hall of Shame. You broke it down. I mean, that was somebody's grandmother.
Come on.
Wow.
Yeah, right?
All because she looked at him?
Didn't some Mexican drug dealer who was in prison clock the passenger on an NYC subway that did the same thing?
Yes.
Because the passenger glanced at him?
Yes.
Hey, like I said, when it comes to New York, please use precaution.
Big time.
May say I love New York, but in certain places, New York does not love you back.
But I still love the Bronx, regardless.
Of course, because of the elevated trains. But also, the New York Puerto Rican Parade coming up on Fifth Ave on June 9th.
Yeah.
And this past event at the NAN convention, and I still say NYC is the best city in the world, even though New York is so damn dirty.
Oh, yeah.
The whole damn city needs to be cleaned.
Right.
It was worse during the 80s. Grand Central Station was a mess back then.
Oh, yeah.
It smelled bad back then.
You ain't never
But
lied.
It's not like that now. I like the new and improved Grand Central Station.
Me
right.
Too.
Penn Station in New York is about to get a big, huge facelift.
Yeah, right.
I like Penn Station, but this is long overdue.
And once they fix that station up, they're going to get rid of the bums, too.
Right.
Just like they did with Grand Central Station. Because right now, there's homeless people sleeping overnight at Penn Station.
Yeah, I've seen that.
I slept over at Penn Station at one time because I missed my 9 o'clock train back to Boston. Once 5 o'clock came around, the NYPD will wake your ass up.
Yep.
That's the thing about Penn Station.
Right?
The police don't let nobody sleep through the day down at Penn Station.
No.
And I still would choose NYC over Boston any day.
Oh, you ain't never lied.